So, welcome to this firewall project. On this firewall project here, there are four main things that you're supposed to know, because this project is not really hard. You're mainly supposed to know what is a firewall, how to use a firewall maybe, how to configure it, and how to maybe allow certain ports and then maybe refuse certain ports. Yeah, so from the broken information that we've been given here, as you can see here, so since we set up three servers, so one server that was carrying web server 1, the other one was carrying web server 2, and this other one here was carrying the load balancer 1 here. So on this firewall here, so both firewalls are supposed to be set up in such a way that they will be securing web server 1, 2, and 3. But then it's not compulsory in this case. The only compulsory option here, you are only supposed to do it in web server 1. So if you think you want to do it in web server 2, feel free. And also in web server 3, feel free. You are not going to be denied any marks. But then I'd say just do it in both of them, because since it's an ongoing project, you're going to see the beneficial in the end. Yeah. So Today I wanted us to go through the web server project. Yeah, I had already prepared some notes on it, but then I got home late, that's why we didn't do it. Yeah, so we are going to do it, we are still going to do it, but then not just today. I've already prepared everything about it. I've already done some background check on it also. So we are going to, maybe tomorrow or the day after that, on Wednesday that is, so we're going to look for a day and then do all that. So we're going to do the web server and then finish on that, go to SSL, HTTPS and SSL, configure it, and then also finally go to the load balancer, configure it together, and then now try hosting it so that everybody can be on the same page here, because this is really important. But then, so don't worry. For those who are reaching out saying you have a problem in this project here, yeah, don't worry. But I'm still figuring it out. Yeah, the session already been planned, so we are going to do them. So just don't worry.
Ever since you left, when you left for fasting, yeah, there have been so many challenges. When you left for fasting, there have been so many challenges in the group.
Yeah,
okay. So many people are saying until when Ahmed comes back, or so we don't want to disturb you at all.
Yeah, but then don't
think of yeah, brief. Yes, yes, thank you.
Yeah, it's okay. It's okay. You know, personally, I wanted us to do this using one session, but then somebody said it's not a good idea, because if we rush it, then we'll get the
assets. Lois said that.
Yeah.
Lois said that. There's no point just rushing it without gaining anything. So you better to do it one after the other and benefit.
Exactly. So the web server part of it, the practical server, is already planned. Now we're only looking for a day, and then we'll do it after the web server, and then we'll also look for a day, do HTTPS and SSL, and then finally finish on the load balancer, and then test it. In case maybe you are having a problem on your own domain name, we're also going to work on it. Yeah, personally I just use .tech domains. If any people say it's a little bit complicated, I normally think it's good. So here,
you know, so many.
Yeah.
So many people send a lot of messages to you on domain name.
Yeah.
So many people find it so difficult. Another time you are so busy, you just come to the group, respond to them, you tell them, you get back to them. But I know because of the fasting, it has been so tight.
Yeah, but then finally it's over. Yeah, so it ended last week. So
yeah, I know.
We must finish this, guys. Don't worry. We are going to do this together. So the background information here, for those who did the Webstack debugging project, I know you have a little background idea on how to do this, but then even if you still didn't do it either way, so I'm jumping this for those maybe who didn't do the web debugging project, and then come here. So one thing you're supposed to do to make sure here is, when setting up your firewall, make sure that you don't deny port 22, because usually logging using TCP, we're using SSH. So if by mistake you disable port 22 and then you don't enable it back again, you won't be able to log into your server using SSH. So
which one is port 22?
Yeah, we're going to see it right now. So the port 22 is the one that allows us to log into our web server using SSH. So by mistake, if you maybe, so while you're setting up your firewall, if by mistake you configure it to deny port 22, you won't be able to log in using SSH. So you should be really, really careful on that.
What's the function of that port?
So this port, okay, we can say, let me just give you an example. Right now, for example, maybe you're going home, right? So there's a method of transportation you normally use to get home. Is that right, Gabriel? Yeah.
Yes, yes.
So for an instance now, maybe when you are going home a certain day, you get the method, the road you normally use, or maybe you can say the method you normally use to get home is maybe closed. Is there a way that you can use to get home again? You'll be stuck, right?
Yes.
So now port 22, we can say it's a road. So it's a road that allows us to communicate with our server using SSH. So by mistake,
just like a door passage.
Yeah, exactly. So if we close it, we won't be able to log into our server using SSH. So that's why we are saying we should be really, really careful that every time you are setting up your firewall, after you are done, make sure you enable it. Yeah. So I don't think there's anything else here. Yeah. Most importantly, it was port 22, because without port 22, you won't be able to log into your server using SSH, and that is the configuration which you're supposed to use. Yeah. So first thing first here, you are okay. Before this, let us do a small introduction on what is a firewall, and then we'll get back to the project. Yeah. So this one is supposed to be a small PLD, because this project is really simple, as you can see. Personally, I've already done it. Yeah. I even did the advanced project because it was really simple. It was just editing something out, and then we're just done. Yeah. So
we've not even done it to put us through so that the checker can pass through.
Yeah. So don't worry about the checkers. Also, the checkers, as you can see, that everything is correct. So we're going to see that in a minute. So let's see. Who is the TL? Yeah. So what is a firewall? So as you all know, guys, I won't talk about sessions. So number one, what is a firewall? Yeah. So don't worry about even the remaining the projects that you are not able to do our PLDs on them. We are still going to do them. Don't worry about that. So just a matter of time. So what is a firewall? Let me start with Gabriel, because you're the one who started the PLD together. So Gabriel, in your own words, what do you think is a firewall?
A firewall is like a server that needs to protect your web server from attack.
Okay, you're saying it's a server that protects your web server?
Yes, from attacks.
Okay, let me do this. Sorry about that, let me do this. Okay, so Gabriel is saying it's a server that protects your web server.
Against attack.
Yeah, so that protects one's web server. So web server against attacks. So against attacks, okay.
The attack can be incoming or incoming network traffic or outgoing network traffic.
So either incoming / outgoing.
Outgoing.
Yeah, okay. Thank you for that, Gabriel. Okay, sorry about that. So thank you for that. Let me see who is else. Okay, I know somebody. Frederick. Hey, Frederick. Is Frederick around? Hello Frederick. Okay, I don't think he's around. So okay, I don't think he's around. Okay, we'll just continue. Yeah, so as a firewall is just, you can say, okay, yeah, it's just a software. It can be a software and it can still be a hardware. But then you can just say also that it's a server that protects one web server against attacks. But then all you can remember here, or what you should know here, is that it can be am I writing that? So it can be a software. So it can be a software slash. So it can be a software slash hardware. So most people usually just think that servers can that firewalls can only be softwares. But then for today's PLD, we know that a server, it can be a software or it can be hardware. So depending on how it's configured, that's how it's going to work. So that's the important thing here. So from just knowing what is a firewall, because you can't maybe configure something without knowing what to configure. So first thing first, what is a firewall? We've said, so Gabriel has told us that way, but then it depends on how you understand it. But then the most important thing here is that to know that a firewall is something that protects your web server against attacks, either incoming or outgoing. So that's okay. So because of time, so in case I'm moving quickly, you just let me know, because I'm just doing this because of time. So uses of firewall. Okay, maybe before that, I'll go with, okay, let me just go in uses, and then we'll go types, uses of firewalls. Firewalls, yeah. So number one, as Gabriel has already told us, so protection.
Protection and security.
Yeah, so protection of incoming slash outgoing requests. Maybe I'll say that requests, because remember what you said about web servers. So web servers, basically their work is to, or maybe let's say the whole internet is based on requests and responses. So one is that protection, and then so we can also say security. I think it will be a repetition in a way, but then security also. Yeah, security, and then maybe I'd say one other thing. I say specification. And this specification, all I mean here is that, so the firewall specifies, helps us to specify what we want in our network, or maybe to be allowed in our web servers. Because in most situations, a lot of hackers just go to your websites and try malicious things there, and then they try also sending things in your in a user's browser when he tries to get a web server. So the firewalls are what will help us to protect against that. So even if a user tries to do harmful things, the firewall will help us to protect against that. So specification. So as I always say, it depends on how you understand these things. So my explanation will be different, maybe different from how you understood it, but either way, the same thing is that specification. Yeah, the same concept is that. I don't think, okay, maybe is there anyone else who maybe wants to add the uses of firewalls? Because I think the most important thing is protection and security for going and incoming. Those are the most important things here. We should know about the importance of firewalls. The rest, I'll just add them up. Yeah, so as I already said, in case you feel like I'm too fast, you just have to let me know. Yeah, so just doing this because, so types of firewalls, okay, we didn't talk about this. So types of firewalls, yeah, types of firewalls. So there are just two types of firewalls. There are two types of firewalls. Okay, can someone help me here? So type number one.
Yeah. Network.
Yeah, network. Yeah. So network firewalls. And then number two.
Maybe host name.
Yeah, host based firewalls. Okay. Firewalls. Yes, firewalls. Yeah, I think that's that. So okay. Maybe we can talk a little bit on network firewalls. So network firewalls. Yeah, we just let me see if I've already installed something here so that we can do this manually practically. So let me see.
This was that one.
Okay, you can see that. Okay, so network firewalls. So, what do you think network firewalls? Okay, or well, maybe what are the benefits of network firewalls? Or maybe what can make us put up network firewalls? So, let me see. Okay, Gabriel, I think we're just together. So, what do you think can make us go for network firewalls? What is the reason to that? Or maybe the importance of putting up network firewalls? So
The major reason we are using network firewall is that maybe probably you use network firewall when one web server is down.
Yeah.
You can easily switch to the other web server.
Okay, personally I think I'll disagree with you here, because the network firewalls here, they help us so that we can, how will I say this? Okay, let me do this practically here so that you can see this. So okay, now for example here, let me just see, enter. So the network firewalls will be beneficial in situations where we want our web servers to only allow traffic from certain networks, because other types of networks are usually corrupted. So that's why we normally set up network firewalls. So I think that's the setting up network firewalls.
Okay,
sorry about that. Sorry. So maybe to just protect, or maybe to make our web servers to allow certain packets from certain networks only, to allow traffic, let me see, just traffic, I think this is better, from certain networks only. I think this is the most important reason for putting up network firewalls, because as I was telling you the other time, now you're building your website, maybe it has few leads, so networks so hackers won't see the benefits of hacking your website. But then once it starts generating a lot of leads, a lot of people starts coming into your website now it starts attracting a lot of people. So from those people, some of them are usually bad, they're hackers, so they try to log into your web server so that they can maybe pass some certain information from there, because a lot of people usually go there. So So one benefit of putting up a network firewall is so that our web servers can only allow traffic from certain networks only. Yeah, because as you can see here, so the firewall is usually set. Okay, not yeah, this one here. The firewall is usually set so that any request before interacting with our web server is first filtered out. So if the network doesn't meet the required specification or maybe the configuration, it's not allowed. Yeah, so I think that's that. So I won't talk a lot on that because of time. So number two, host-based. So host-based firewalls. So firewalls. Gabriel, will you help me with this? So what do you think are the importance of host-based firewalls? Or maybe what are they?
I don't have an idea of this one.
Okay, let me see if we have someone here. Okay, Michael left. Okay. Host-based firewalls, what I can say about this is, what I can say about host-based firewalls is just a first, we can just say that this is just a software. So this is just a software. This is just a software that runs on an individual computer. Yeah. So it provides on an individual computer, providing protection by monitoring the incoming and outgoing network traffic. So the major difference between the network firewall and the host-based firewalls, you can say that the host-based belongs to the certain computer, the individual computer. The network firewall doesn't belong to one particular computer. Yeah. So I think that's the best difference between the two. So when asked about the host-based firewall, this belongs to an individual computer. So it works based on the configuration made by that computer. So in case you say, I only want, you can say IPv4 only because now IPv6 is only available, because, so you'd be limiting other people. But then, in short, this depends on how you want. So maybe if you want packets that will be flowing only through port 22, you can do that. Maybe also you can say about which port are again. You can say port 80 for HTTP, and also you can say maybe traffics that allow for port 443. I hope it's 443, which is I think this is HTTPS. HTTPS, yeah.
Yes.
So this is just based on you. So you are the one who configures these.
Which one is port 80? What does it work for? Port 80.
Port 80. So port 80 allows traffic allows HTTP traffic. And this example, you can say, for example, when you load a page, or maybe when you go to a certain website, so the website, it depends with the website itself, of course. So in case the website uses HTTP, then the website will be served to you with using port 80. But then when it uses HTTPS, it will be served to you using port 443. I don't know if we're together on that. Hey, Gabriel.
Yes.
Yeah. But then that's the major difference. Yeah. So host-based firewalls, you're dependent. But then this other one here, you're not dependent. So I know there's a lot we are not talking about on network firewalls, but then most of the things we are not talking about are majorly just theory work, so I think we can read about those. And then now we can say number three is how to configure firewall. Yeah, how to configure firewalls. Okay, by default I think when you install any Debian version comes installed with a firewall, but then it's usually not enabled. Yeah, so if you want to see this, you can just run, it's usually not really hard. So when you just want to see if it's allowed, so you can just say, okay, allowed, just say sudo ufw, I think it's service. Let me see, enable. Okay, let me see the status first of all. Okay, as you can see here, it's active. So this is our firewall here, so it's active. So it's active, so
what does this stand for?
Now that's the
what does that you stand for?
The okay, uncomplicated. It's uncomplicated. And I was supposed to ask that question. And I'm complicated. Let me just write it in full here. See in full. Let me just write it here down and here up. So UFW in full. So is equals to uncomplicated firewall. Yeah, that's it. Firewall. I think this basically means it's just a file, but then it doesn't have a lot of configuration. It's just simple. Anyone can work with it, even if you're just a beginner. So that's why it is called uncomplicated firewall. Yeah. So whenever you just want to see if the status of it, you just run sudo complicated firewall status, and then you'll be told. So by default, you should usually disable. But then when you
You can run it like this on Ubuntu, right?
Yeah, you can just run it. If you run it on Ubuntu, it's going to tell you whether it's active or not active. So for my instance here, you can see it's saying status is active because you already enabled it. But then if you didn't enable it, it's going to tell you. So one thing here, let us finish this quickly before we jump here in this practical part of it. So I think that's that. And then so how to configure a firewall. So whenever we want to configure a firewall, we have to access the file. We have to access a file called. Let me. I don't think I can change the color about this one. But then the it's yeah, I think it's this CTL. Yeah, I think this is the file you're supposed to configure. Whenever you want to make any changes to the firewall, or maybe any configuration, the same way whenever you want to make any configuration to Nginx file to Nginx, usually go to var, depending on which you want to do, whether you want to talk about the sites enabled or sites disabled. So you just go to the where. So see. Yeah, so you just go to var www.html when you want to serve new, maybe when you want to put new items that will be served, or new documents, so that it's static, dynamic, depending on what you want. So I think that's that. So whenever you want to configure a firewall, you just go to this file here. So this file here, you'll see a lot of configuration. You can just go there and see it. Let me just go there. Just going to see it. We're not going to do any configuration, but then we're just going to make sure that it's available. I think this is it. Okay, no, it's not that. Should be really, really, really careful with the spelling, cause one small mistake, you can just see it's sudo. Let me just see.
What are you doing now? Sudo, which one?
Okay, all I want to show
you. What is this one?
This one is just going to show us the where the just to show you the configuration for the firewall. Or maybe we'll see the limit. We'll just come back here later. Let's just do that. So the last thing here is how to allow ports. Yeah, just do that and then we start. So number four, can say how to allow ports. Yeah, so depending on what. Now this is the different configuration. So this one, you don't have to do it the same way I'm going to do it here. So it depends with you. So once you have installed your firewall and then everything is set up. So when you want traffic from certain ports to be allowed, you have to name the ports here, because if you don't name the ports here, then they won't be allowed. So for example, if you want, for example, I'm just going to use certain examples, but then you can do more. So for example, if you want to enable port 22, all you just do is sudo the firewall itself and then allow port 22. So TCP. So for example, maybe you want to allow another port 14, let's say port 80. You just use the same command. The only thing that changes is here, it's 80, because the connection that's going to be established between the browser and the server is going to be a TCP or IP connection. So that doesn't change. FW, that's the firewall, and then allow port 80, let's say 80, so TCP. So this TCP, I've already told you why we are putting it here. This is due to the connection that is usually formed between the client and then the client's browser and the web server here and the server itself, that is going to be a TCP connection. So I think this is it. This is the most important thing you're supposed to know here in this project. What is the firewall itself? Maybe know how to use the firewall, know how to configure the firewall itself. Yeah, and also know the different types of firewalls, and then finally know to how to allow certain ports. So this one is important for configuration. Yeah, configuration. For allowing incoming traffic. Yeah, I think this is it. So Gabriel, are we still together?
Yes.
Okay. So I think this is it.
Yes.
This is just the theory. I noticed that it didn't have a lot of theory, so that's why I just did this quickly. So now let's come back here to the project itself. Now let's do this. Let me just do this so that let me just do this one here. Okay, we'll come back there. Come back there. So let me just go to the directory itself. So first thing first, you're supposed to create the directory. So first of all, so as you can see here, so in a case where you don't have a firewall, traffic will be coming, going out without you doing anything. So that's why maybe people will come, inject other things, inject viruses in your SQL database. It will lead to bad things. Yeah, so once we start talking about that, we'll see how SQL injection is done. But then for the moment, I think this is that. So you should, this is what I was telling you. So after enabling port 22, you should be really careful to enable it. So because if you don't enable it, then it won't allow incoming traffic to flow using that port. Yeah. So first thing first, you're supposed to go through the quiz. Yeah, I think that's one easy, because the quiz will just, what you've talked about will basically just answering the quiz, because what is the function of the firewall? It's just to filter incoming and outgoing network traffic. I don't know why they repeated the same question. Maybe I think so that you can really understand. The same thing, what is the main function of the firewall? It's just to filter incoming and outgoing network traffic. What is a firewall? It's just a hardware or a software network system. Same thing. Two types, network and host based. And then finally, yeah, I think that's that. Let me just try this. Because they were just two questions. I don't know why they were doing that. So, first thing first here. So, let me log into my server. Because all of this, clear. Another thing I notice about people, a lot of people don't really know the importance of this diagram that you are normally given here. So first thing first, in a case you are given a project and then it has this diagram here, make sure you first of all look at it so that you know how it flows. So in this case here, we have been told to configure our firewalls to be in either web server 1, web server 2, or in the and then in the load balancer itself. So not in your own terminal. So all of this we are going to do it in our web server 1. So first thing first, you start with entering into your web server 1. So Ubuntu at the IP address.
I can't see your terminal.
Okay. Oh. Okay. Sorry about that. Let me just maximize. Okay. What about now? Can you see it?
Yes.
Okay. So okay. So let me just copy this and then can go there. Okay. So. First thing first, all this project about the firewall, you're supposed to do it in the web server 1. So that's why I'm first logging into web server 1 using SSH Ubuntu at this, and then I press enter. So let's just give it a minute. I hope it won't fail. Yeah, as you can see. So as you can see, I'm now inside web server 1. So I don't know how I'll do this. I wanted, okay, let me do this. I wanted to
okay, before
respond.
you start,
Yeah.
You have to log into your web server first.
Yeah, because the reason to us why we are logging into your own server is because Alex is the one who told us to do that. Alex was saying, let's install the firewall and set up few rules on web server 1. So that's why we are doing it in our web server 1, not in our own Ubuntu terminal. We are doing it in web server 1. So basically, first thing first, you make sure you log in into web server 1. So if you didn't do your server and SSS project well, you won't be able to log in into web to your web server. So that's the first thing you're supposed to know here. So now after logging in into your web server, so let me minimize this. I want to minimize this and my terminal so that my terminal can be still here. Yeah. Okay, can you see my terminal right now? Hey Gabriel, can you see my terminal? Hello Gabriel. Okay, I think we've lost Gabriel. Maybe it's internet connection. So I think I'll just continue. So first thing first here, so you're logging into your web server 1. So after logging into your web server 1 now, you do this. So as usual, so let's say maybe you go into a system that doesn't have that, that's the web, the firewall is not installed by default. So what are we going to do first thing? The first thing we are going to do here is install it. So we just do sudo. Sorry about that. I'm still typing the other one. So sudo, just do sudo apt. First thing first, always remember you should do an upgrade before installing anything. So upgrade. So and then it's a yes always. So that, so yeah. Oh, this one is going to take a lot. I've upgraded instead of updating. So because of time, I don't want to cancel it. But then let's see. It's okay. I think things just finishing up. You just give it some few seconds. But then don't forget about this one, guys. Yeah. About this one. If you forget to did if you deny the port and then forget to return it back again, you are really going to find it hard to log in. So don't forget about this one here. So I've already done that. So first thing first, you've already logged in here. I said you've already logged in to web server one. So Gabriel. Okay, I don't know who's around, but then okay. Let's just give this a minute to finish upgrading. So now the requirements here, first thing first, we have been told in our task zero we're supposed to block all incoming traffic, but then we should configure our firewall so that it blocks all incoming traffic except port 22, port 443 and port 80. So in our answer file here, we should share the commands that we have used so that to make this happen. I think we are together up to there. Yeah. So I won't update one more time. I've upgraded it, but then I think we don't know about that. So let's say that was an update, and then now we sudo. This we are only doing this in a case where now you didn't get the firewall installed. But then in my case, while I install this Ubuntu terminal here, I already found it installed. So I'm just doing this for those who maybe downloaded a latest version that doesn't have this. So you sudo apt install ufw. Yeah. So because I've already installed it, you see that you're going to see this here. So that's why you're told.
Okay, when you get into your web,
pardon?
You will log into your web server.
Yeah.
When you get into your web server, you now do sudo apt install.
Yeah. Okay. Okay. That's what I was saying. It depends on your web server. I think Ubuntu terminal. I think by default it comes installed, but then not enabled. So but then. It doesn't harm, because remember this is web server one. This one is not your own terminal. This one is a server somewhere else. So we don't know how it's configured. So for six, we're just going to install it again. So that's why you first do an update, sudo apt update. So sudo apt get update or sudo apt update, and then next we sudo apt install. The firewall, if it's already installed, you're going to see the firewall is already installed to the newer version. In case it's not a newer version, it's going to be upgraded, and then after that you're done. So this one, don't worry about ALX system engineering DevOps. We're going to see about this one while we'll be going through the web server projects. Yeah, so I just clone this so that I can be able to install the Nginx from here. So after that, the next thing now here, we're supposed now to, as you can see in this task here. Okay, Gabriel, I don't know if you can see my terminal and my project interface at the same time. Can you see my internet page here?
Yes.
Okay, sure.
Yes.
So after doing this, the next thing you're supposed to do here, you're supposed now to deny, because you've been told block all incoming traffic. So first thing first, we are going to block all traffic that will be coming to our web server, and then and then enable only port 22, 443, and port 80. Are we together there?
Yes. Oh, I wanted to log in with my system.
Okay.
I just got one now.
Okay. Sure. Okay, so you just do sudo. So now this command here is the one that is going to block all incoming traffic. So first thing first, we block all incoming traffic, and then after blocking them, and then enable only port 22, and then 443, and port 80. So first thing first, we are blocking all incoming traffic. Yeah, so block all incoming traffic. So first, UFW. So because these are default options, so that's why we're putting the default figure here. So deny incoming, they're saying incoming, so incoming. If it was saying maybe out, then it's only 1M. I think that's that. So if it was maybe they were, in case they were saying block all outgoing, we could have placed here outgoing. I think this is the command. Yeah,
you're using a command.
Yeah, now this is the command.
You're using a command.
Yeah.
Why do you normally use sudo? What is the major use of that?
You normally use sudo to so that, okay, in case I'm not using sudo here, okay, let me see the best way to explain this. Simple. For example, you have given your own computer to your, maybe to your daughter or maybe to your brother, all right? And then in your own computer, you have some files or maybe some certain things that are really, really, really important to you. So you had put them in a safe folder and then set a password for them. So every time you want to access that folder, you first of all have to input your password. So when you give your laptop to another person, if it tries to log in to access that folder, it'll be required to input a password. So because he's not the root password, or maybe because he's not the owner, he would be able to access it because it's protected. So we normally use sudo to say that we are the owner, or we have all privileges in this server. I don't know if you're getting me there, Gabriel. Are we together?
Yes.
Yeah. So I don't know if you have got what I'm trying to say.
I get the concept.
Oh yeah. So basically that's it. Sudo, we normally just sudo to say we are the owner, so we have all privileges in this computer. So don't deny me anything I'm trying to do. Simple. So that's why. So first of all, we are going to say sudo. So because I'm the owner, so don't deny anything. So I want you to deny all incoming traffic and then press enter. Yeah, as you can see here, it's saying default incoming policy change to deny. As you can see here. So after denying this, everything here is going to change. every incoming traffic here is going to be denied. But then Alex didn't stop there. It's saying so deny all incoming traffic, but then configure your firewall so that it affects traffic from SSH, HTTPS, and HTTP. So after doing that, the only other thing you're supposed to do here is just sudo. It's just now allow these traffics. So sudo. This is the remaining thing. So sudo ufw. Allow. First of all, it started to 22 TCP. I hope you are together why we're using TCP here. Why I'm putting TCP after post 22.
Why?
Yeah, because the browser, for the packets to be sent between the browser and our server, there's a connection that is usually formed. So that connection is usually a TCP / IP connection. So that's why we are saying after the connection is made, so any incoming traffic from port 22, after the TCP connection is made, it should be allowed. So that's why we are using port 22 here. We are using TCP. Okay. So it's accepting from 22, also accepting from 80. Yeah. And then also from, so, also what other thing? It's 443. Yeah, 443. Just put 443 there. Don't forget about all these commands we have used here. So the first command we have used was to upgrade, to update, and then install it, and then finally allow these options. Yeah. So I don't know if we're together up to there.
Yes. I'm finished.
So finally, after allowing all of them, you now enable our firewall. So how do we do this? We just do sudo uf firewall enable. simple. Yeah, I know. Don't worry about this command. It's going to do that. Firewall is active and enabled on system setup. Yeah. So to confirm if it's okay, if you do this, if you SSH into Ubuntu using your username, it's supposed to accept. If by mistake you didn't enable it and you disabled everything, this won't be able. Don't forget about this one here. So that's that. We are done with that. So as you can see, so that's what I did, and then I just did my, and then so in your answer file, you're just supposed to do all the commands that you've used. Just put them in your answer file, and then push, and then that will be okay.
Hello, bro.
Yes.
I want to join with my system, and I want to disable this one.
Okay, sure. But sure, just use your system. But then, I think it's only these advanced tasks remaining, and then it'll be done. So okay. So now on this port forwarding, on this advanced project here. So this was the only mandatory project here. So if you want to do this, Alex said basically we should only do it on web server 1, but then in case you want to do it in web server 2 and the balancer project also, the web balancer server also, you're allowed. So it depends with you. So after that, you now come to the advanced part. So in this advanced part here, you've been told, so firewalls can only filter requests that they can also. Firewalls cannot only filter requests, but also can forward them. So in this here, in this task one here, in this advanced task, you're only supposed to configure your web one so that it redirects port 8080 TCP to port 80 TCP. So your answer should contain the configuration file. So in this task here, the only thing they wanted us here to mention, or maybe to talk about here, they wanted us to research on how, let me show you, because already in this, because of the spellings, they're a little bit challenging. Yeah, this is the spelling. Yeah. So here, in task one here, the Alex just wanted us to know about the file in which we are supposed to configure to allow this. So in order to configure the firewall itself, you're supposed to use this file here. This is the file. This is where the configuration file is. Like in Nginx, this is a configuration file. So firewalls also have configuration files. So this is where the configuration files are. So you just sudo, just vi, depending with what you want. So because I'm a Vim user, so I normally use vi. If you use a Max, just use a Max to open it, or if you prefer Nano, just use Nano to open it. If you press enter.
Hello, bros.
Hello, brother.
Are you with me?
Yeah, we're still together.
Yes. What I'm going to do now, yes. Can I share my screen so that I can also see what I can do that task one?
Okay, just a minute. Let me finish up on this one. Just a minute.
Okay.
Finally, here, after coming inside this file, you're only supposed to come here and to uncomment this line that enables packet forwarding. So after doing that, after uncomment, so by default this file was commented, so just uncomment it, and then after uncommenting it, save, control C, or depending the one you use. So personally I use Vim, so I'll just escape and then save that, and then now and then copy that file. And then copy this file here, paste it in this answer file here, and then push, and then you'll be done. So that's that. Escape. Something really, these are really easy things. Yeah, so
it's very easy for you. We are just coming up. We are learner.
Yeah, so this is it for this project. So thank you for watching, and in case you liked it, just give us a like, subscribe and share. Yeah, see you next time.
Yes, hold on.